All right, so let's start with the very first technique, which I call progress hack. What I would like to start out with is that the one thing I realized early on is that the number one reason why people stop progressing in their practice is because they stop doing what worked for them from the very beginning. It's straightforward and a no-brainer that if you want to progress over your current abilities, the thing to practice that would create the most progress for you wouldn't be practicing something you can already do, but needs to be something that overcomes your current limits and pushes you. That's why, interestingly, we tend to do a lot of things right at the beginning stages of practicing a skill. Whenever we just start out learning a skill from zero, we are immediately pushing our limits, and as a result, we progress. It's the reason why progress at the beginning stages tends to happen rapidly and predictably, because we push ourselves almost continually. The problem actually starts once you start advancing and fill up your practice session with things that aren't new or pushing your skills anymore, and this happens gradually. When the routine becomes the priority in your practice session, instead of pushing your skills further, that's where you get stuck. Once you get to this point, there never seems to be enough time to practice all the things that you can already do, as well as practice as many new and harder tricks as you did when you just started out and progressed rapidly. So, how can you make time for new things if you don't even have time to practice the tricks you already have and work on? What is the best way to prioritize the new tricks and get the maximum effect? But most importantly, where should you put a new trick in your practice session? The progress hacking technique is the basis of the practice code that answers these questions. But before I can show you how it works, I need to introduce to you some key ideas this strategy is based on. And one of the most important theories I built my technique upon is the 99% theory, which explains a lot of our psychological behavior, not only about our way we tend to usually practice our routines, but also the way we go about routines in all of our life. So, here it is in short. The 99% rule comes from behavioral scientists who found out that 99% of what we usually do and think today are almost exactly the same things we did and thought the day before. And that's true for almost every day in our lives. 99% of the emotions that you feel is the same as you had the day before. 99% of your actions and the ways you do them and how you move is the same as the day before once you established your daily routine. This might be very familiar to your practice as well. Once you established a certain set of routines which take up all of your time in your practice session and completely filled it up, there's rarely any time left for the new. That process of habiting is also called myelination by modern neuroscience. Myelination is a process where paths are paved inside our mind, similarly like a highway is paved, and it's literally paving a road on which we follow through each time we come to the same situation. The very first time we choose and make a decision, the road has been chosen, but as we continue to take the same pathways, it becomes easier each time to go on the same road the next time and the next time. And we keep paving over it once we start using them without even much realizing it. So in order to connect this concept to practicing, I have a simple question for you. If your practice session consists of 99% the same things you do basically every day, day after day, do you challenge yourself enough throughout the day in your practice sessions? What would you say how much of the things that you practice every day and the routines that you go about are the same difficulty as yesterday and the day before? The reality is that if 99% of what you do in your practice is almost the same as the day before, your results are changing slowly as well, at best maybe 1% a day. Remember when you just started out practicing your skill and progressed rapidly? What was the percent rate of new things pushing your limits at that time? If you watch any master in their skill, do you believe they got to their level by doing 99% or 100% of their practice exactly the same way as the day before? Or did they push themselves the right amount every single day systematically? Now, of course, the answer is not as easy to just push yourself further. We already know we have to push our limits in order to progress, but it's only one part of the equation. The deciding factor is something entirely else, and without it, it just won't work. In the next section, I'm going to show you the unconventional strategy that is capable to keep you always growing in every single practice session and ignite the same progress speed back into your life as when you just started out your practicing.